We've all gotten cut or scraped at one point in our lives. Or if you're like me, a lot of points. What do our bodies do after we get cut? Ever noticed one of these bad babies? This is what we scientists call a scab. How does it form? Well, I'm glad you asked. When we get cut or scraped, the top layer of our skin breaks and blood flows through the opening, kind of like when a dam breaks. Imagine this. Seconds after we get cut, the body does three things. First, it sends out white blood cells to keep out infection. Think of the beavers as white blood cells.
Hey, that paper drum.
Second, sticky blood cells form called platelets, and they make a clot to stop you from losing more blood, like the wood beavers use to block a leak. Third, thread-like proteins called fibrins form throughout the clot to hold it in place and create a protective barrier, like the mud squished between the logs. As the fibrin and platelets dry out, a scab forms, and skin cells underneath it create a new layer of fresh, uncut skin.
Hey, scientist. It can take up to 2 weeks for a scab to fall off. I know, that's a long time, but don't pick it. It can start the process all over again and can end up leaving a scar. Oh yes, put a bandage over your scab if you get the urge to itch.
Experiment time! Well, this is actually more of a demonstration, or as we scientists say, a demo. All you need is a balloon, some water, something to catch a spill, a pin or needle, get a grown-up to help you here for safety, some toilet paper, and duct tape. Not duct tape, duct tape. Take a balloon and fill it with water. Carefully use a sewing needle to poke a hole in the balloon. Next, take a piece of toilet paper and try to cover the hole. This is like the platelets forming a clot. You'll see the paper gets wet quickly. Try covering it with a piece of duct tape. Is it still leaking? The duct tape is like the fibrin after it dries. It forms a barrier so liquid cannot flow. To make this demo an experiment, try blocking the leak with different materials and take notes on what you discover.
Be safe out there, scientists. It's no fun getting hurt. But if an accident happens, you know what to do. What are other ways to stay safe while doing science? What do you think, scientist?
Some ways to stay safe during science is to wear goggles and a lab coat and stay like a few feet away from your experiment.
Wear a hat that covers your ears.
And wear a gas mask so the smoke doesn't come into your mouth.
Be careful of what you're doing and make smart choices about what you're doing too.